Welcome back to NTV Weekend Edition. Now, 70 students from Hillside Endarasha Academy are still missing following the fire tragedy that claimed 70 lives. 14 others are receiving treatment at various hospitals in Nyeri County. Here's Margaret Kimathi with that report.
Emotions ran high at Hillside Endarasha Academy after parents viewed charred remains of their children. Their face full of sadness, tears and sorrow. What happened to them last night will forever ring in their minds. John Moraithi arrived here at midnight after he heard the fire brigade siren. He had come to look after his grade 6 grandson, who has not been found so far.
Sasa nikaingia kwa gari yangu, nikaifuatilia mpaka hapa. Sasa nilifika hapa kama saa 6 hivi, saa 6 na robo hivi. Mjuku wangu ndio anasoma hapa grade 6. Na ni mmoja wa wale ambao hata sasa bado patikana, lakini tuna matumaini ya kwamba atapatikana.
Kuna mzazi alinipigia simu ambaye ni jirani katika kwa shule hii, kaniambia wako na huyo kijana wangu. Na akampatia simu tukaongea naye, akaniambia kumechomeka lakini yeye ako safe.
The fire started at around 11 p.m. on Thursday while learners were sleeping. According to eyewitnesses, the fire broke out in the boys' dormitory where there were 156 students. 16 people died at the scene while one more succumbed to injuries in hospital. The fire was first responded to by Kiawara fire engineers who sought backup from the Nyeri Town's fire engine department after realizing that the fire was too big. The fire was put out at 3 a.m.
Tukakimbia na tukitumia pikipiki. Kufika ndio tukapata hata kuna watu washafika waking'ang'ana kuzima hiyo moto wakitumia maji ya hiyo tu shule. Na wakapigia zimamoto. Zimamoto ilikuwa inatoka ni kilomita kama 12. Lakini jia ilikuwa mbaya. Jia ni mbaya, ni chafu sana.
This school has 824 students, with 316 students being boarders. Some parents came to school and picked their students, and now the basic education PS Billy Kipsang has urged them to inform the school administration for easy tracing.
Together with a team from the county, they have been able to counsel our parents, counsel our children. The teachers, I know sometimes we forget our teachers, and those are the people who are most affected because these are their children.
Mount Kenya Hospital has been for the time being, designated as our trauma and accident center for this matter. We have boosted the personnel there, and therefore we are going to ensure that every child who went through this trauma will go through Mount Kenya.
Various leaders were also present to assess the situation. Interior CS Kithure Kindiki has warned that the number of affected students may increase. Fears collaborated by Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua.
That some of the children tried to escape the tragedy and they ended up being hosted by neighbors and the community around. And so there are some children who are still alive and well, but they are of course traumatized and they are in the hands of those who gave them refuge last night. And
so far 27 are in hospital, 37 are with parents, one has passed away in hospital, and indeed 86, their whereabouts are known. We still have 70 kids that are unaccounted.
We also have a full team supporting with tracing so that we reconcile the data of the children who are meant to be in this school or who are in this school. And that data will be provided to the authorities so that they can transmit it forward to the parents.
The DCI is yet to determine the cause of the fire, but investigations are ongoing. Margaret Kimathi, NTV.